There's a really good reason we're here today. I mean, in Portage, have you ever in your life ever said, Jesus, I want you to be my Lord in charge of my life?
In charge? No. Have I asked for forgiveness? Yes. Have I gone to church? Yes. But asking him to be in charge of my whole life? No.
Imagine if, like, eternally you had it all spelled out.
Yeah, it'd be great, but I don't even think, you know, the Pope has it spelled out, and he's one of the most holiest men on the face of the earth, so it's really hard to say something like that from a dial. I mean,
just to spell it out.
Right, you couldn't. I mean, it'd be really rough.
A 10-year-old sin?
Oh yeah.
To your sisters?
Oh yeah.
So is this true? We all sin.
Right.
Which would imply it, the wages of sin, what you earn because of sin, is one thing.
Right.
Death.
Right.
You know that's true?
I mean, I think you're born to die.
I've never heard anybody say it like that. But yeah. It's true. You're born to die.
Part of creation and state of the nation, we're asking for us. They were asking for deep restoration and some relocation to what we can trust. Then we turn to...
The key is, it's not the good, it's not the bad, it's Christ is the key.
Right.
So your red is, it's his love.
Okay.
So then on your wristband, that yellow and the black, the sin and the death, is wiped away.
By the blood of Christ.
By the blood of Christ.
Right. Not as a result of works, so that no one may boast.
Now, if the Pope and Gary and Kyle still sin,
right,
there's got to be another answer.
Okay.
Because the goodness doesn't work.
Right.
So if you came before the Lord and you said, well, hey man, here's all my good things.
Mm-hmm.
According to this verse,
you probably shouldn't boast about all the good things that have happened.
It doesn't work.
Right.
To me, I think for you, honestly, is that right there makes a shift in how you perceive God.
Right.
Would you agree?
Yes.
How cool is that? So I'm on a beach in Minnesota, praying about where to go in Indiana, and the Lord said a trailer park, and it's on the map we're given.
Honestly, I believe, like, not even as you get older, as a kid even at the same time, you know, you have a conscience, and I believe, like, the Lord has something to do with your conscience. I've been in a certain, many situations where, you know, I got a bad, like, feeling in my gut that actually told me to stay out of the situation.
Okay.
And, you know, honestly, I feel like that was God, too.
What you're saying is exactly what he's saying. Christ says, you have to give up your life for me to work through you.
Right.
Absolutely, man, it's all over you. It's ridiculous.
The stars were burning through the night.
I have a good friend that he says, some people need a pat on the back.
Yeah.
Say, hey, you can keep going.
Right.
Some people need a hug. You know what you need? You just need a kick in the rear.
Basically.
right?
Yeah.
It just says, go.
I mean, I've been kicking myself for a long time, but maybe I need somebody else to do it too.
My pleasure. Let me do it for you.
Yeah. So I feel like I've made enough mistakes now that I need to just go ahead and just start doing what I need to do for me and the Lord.
And that's today.
Yeah.
It's today, man. It's your wake-up call that says, here we go. Let's do it, Gary.
Right.
You know? Do you agree?
Yeah, I do agree.
I do too.
Yes.
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 We found the
Westward Way. Lord, this is Gary. I just want to let you know that I've been trying my best, and I'm ready to accept you into my life and to let you take control of it. And I hope that things get better for me and my whole family. Amen.